Hello friends, it's 15th March 2020 and again we are in window balcony number 3 and I want to show you a plant that has been quietly stealing the show away from my vision. So let me show you what's going on. Upstairs here, you can see that I've removed the acrylic top over here. Earlier this was till way ahead over there, you know, and it was actually blocking the sun, so we got it removed so that I could put some pots here that will get direct sun. You can see here, this is the serrano chili plant here. It has around 5 peppers right now. What I want to show is the sunshine chili in this yogurt pot. You can see this and see the number of chilies on this plant that is in this 400 ml or 400 gram yogurt pot. It has lot of whitefly. I'm going to give it some treatment, wash off the plant and spray. I'll show you all of that, but look at the chilies in this small pot. So this one gets the liquid fertilizer. The fish emulsion, when it was just in the green growth phase, let me place this here. And when I saw that it started to flower, I started giving it more bloom also. More bloom is 0-10-10. I'll be discussing that in my fertilizer video, which is really overdue, but I was having some technical issues with my computer and hopefully those videos should be up soon. And I give it a small dish underneath because whatever I water in this is not enough for this plant because it's in a really small pot, right? I keep it in this. So when I water this plant, let me just show you how I do that. So you can see the yogurt pot and you can see this plant here. What I do is first I water from top so that the soil is nicely drenched. And then I water in this tray till it's full so that in the course of the day, the plant is going to take up this water as well, and then I water every 2 days. And the last 2 years I've been experimenting and I've seen that when you let the plants grow nice and woody and then transfer them to the final spot, they really do much better than the plants that you transfer into the final spots at an earlier stage. Let me show you the other sunshine chili plant that was also transplanted into the final pot at the same time. So I had 4. So I have one here, one on top there, 2. One more in the living room balcony and one I took to my mom's. That is also doing well. So in the living room space, my chilies are here on the brackets and I've placed holding trays so that I can bottom water them. When the plants are really big, they need more water. And here you can see the sunshine chili plant in this 9 by 12 inch pot, I think. They are ripening as well. But you see the plant, it's not grown that well. It should have been bigger in this pot, but it's not. The one in the grow bag has done better than this, but in comparison, the one in the yogurt pot is kind of singing for some reason. I'm sure it is root bound also, but it's like the perfect size to shift. You just remove the entire plant with the root ball and then put it in the location that you want. So for the spraying, first I'll give my sunshine chili plant a good wash, and then I will spray it with the garlic and neem oil spray. So I'm just going to wash off the leaves of this plant very nicely. You can see, I don't know if you can see the white flies flying off from the plant. Using a jet spray or garden hose is one of the effective methods to get rid of white flies, but you need to do it regularly. And I cannot do this for my plants because then the water will fall on the people passing by in the building and then they will take objection to my... You can see the white fly here. This leaf has come off. Oh, I think there are some aphids as well. Let me show you this. Because this plant is small, I have the luxury of bringing it in to give it a wash like this. And mostly pests are on the undersurface of the leaf. So when we are spraying any remedy, we have to make sure that we spray under the leaves and also above, but definitely undersurface of the leaves cannot be missed, otherwise the spraying would be pointless and ineffective. So now that I'm done with the spraying with water, this is my neem oil and garlic spray. And this kind of spraying again is done before the sun comes out. So either you do it early morning or then you do it in the evening after the sun has gone. Because the pores of the plant are open when the sun is out and you don't want the leaves to get burnt with whatever you are spraying, right? The stomata, they are open for photosynthesis when the sun is out. So here I am spraying the plant very nicely on the undersurfaces. And that's it. This beauty is all set. Just look at this. See the number of chilies. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 I can see, and then there are the teeny tiny ones too. Isn't it awesome? So I hope that you are inspired to try this. Let your plant get to this stage in a yogurt cup. Give it a liquid fertilizer. If you don't use fish emulsion, then you can use panchgavya, you know, in the initial stages in the green growth phase. And then later on you can use jeevamrut or whatever else you are using, banana peel fertilizer, rock phosphate. I have discussed in detail the fertilizers in my tomato and chili growing video, in my sunshine chili detail video itself, so you can have a look at that. I'll put a link. Just wanted to show off this plant. It's just wonderful. Happy growing, everyone. This plant, it remained in this yogurt pot because I didn't have a spot for it, and then I let it be as a backup plant, you know, in case another plant succumbs to something. I'll transfer this one, but just look at it. It's a rock star.